Good morning to all. And today our topic is pests of cruciferous vegetables. The vegetables like cabbage, cauliflower, radish, turnip, nool kol, broccoli, which comes under the cruciferous vegetables. And these vegetables comes under the family Brassicaceae. Next, the important pests observed in these cruciferous vegetables are diamond back moth, cabbage head borer, cabbage leaf borer, cabbage aphid, and cabbage butterfly, and the painted bug. Now we will discuss in detail about the each pest. And the, one of the important pests among these is the diamond back moth, cabbage head borer, and cabbage butterfly. Now, diamond back moth. The scientific name is Plutella xylostella. It belongs to the family Plutellidae and order Lepidoptera. And generally, it will be called as DBM. Shortcut, diamond back moth for shortcut. And coming to the distribution, it is widely distributed. It is the widely distributed pest, and it is a well-known pest of cruciferous vegetables in the world. Next, coming to the marks of identification, this is the diamond back moth. Here the moth is grayish brown in color. The both fore and hind wings are grayish brown in color, and the wings are narrow wings. Grayish brown fore wings with narrow wings, and the fore wings having the pale white triangular marking on the inner margin of the fore wing. Here, this is the inner margin of the fore wing. And this is the pale white triangular marking on the fore wing. When this adult moth comes at rest, these wings are folded over the body. Hence, these triangular markings form the three diamond shaped markings on the dorsal side. This is the diamond shaped markings on the dorsal side of the body. Next, and these and the adult lays about 50 to 60 small whitish eggs singly, and these adult fly lays whitish yellowish white eggs singly along the wings on the underside of the leaves. And these are the eggs of the DBM, diamond back moth. And these eggs are laid along the wings of the leaves. Next, these eggs hatch in about 7 days. Here the egg period is 7 days, and after 7 days the larvae will emerge out from the egg. Here the larvae are greenish in color on the body surface. Short thin hairs are observed. This is the greenish colored larva. Here the both ends of the larvae has the tapering ends. These are the tapering ends here. And it is about 1 to 1.5 centimeter in length. It completes, the larval period is 14 days. And after 14 days, it enter into the pupal stage. Here the Here the pupation takes place in a here the pupation takes place on the leaves within a silken cocoon. This is the silken cocoon, silken cocoon of the pupae. Here the site of pupation is within the silken cocoon. And the pupal period is 7 days. And this entire life, the entire life, it completes in about 24 to 35 days. This is all about the marks of identification and the biology of the DBM, Plutella xylostella. Next, coming to the nature of damage. And these larvae feed by remaining under surface of the leaves, and by feeding on the chlorophyll content of the matter, it leads to the holes on the leaves. And in case of severe infestation, it leads to the skeletonization of the leaves. And at early stages, we can observe the blister spots on the leaves. And if severe infestation will occur, and these holes, hole sizes increased, and withered appearance of the leaves, and it leads to the skeletonization of the leaves. And this is the symptom of the diamond back moth. These are the silken cocoon of the pupa. Next important pest is cabbage head borer, and the scientific name is Helula andalis. Coming to the distribution, Helula andalis, it belongs to the family Pyralidae and the order Lepidoptera. And this pest infests the cabbage, cauliflower, null kohl, and beetroot. And this is the host range for the cabbage borer, Helula andalis. Coming to the marks of identification, here the adult is pale yellowish brown. The forewings of the adult are pale yellowish brown with gray wavy lines on the forewings. Here you can observe on the forewings are grayish brown in color with gray wavy lines on the forewings. And the hind wings are white in color with dark gray border. This is the dark gray border. And these adult moth will lay the yellowish colored oval shaped yellowish eggs on the upper surface of the leaf. And these yellowish eggs are shiny. Here the hatching period is 4 days. After 4 days, the larvae will emerge out from the egg. And here the caterpillar is grayish brown in color with 7 purplish longitudinal stripes on its body, and these are the purplish lines on the body, purplish brown longitudinal stripes, 7 purplish brown longitudinal stripes on the body. And this is the larvae of the Helula andalis, head borer, cabbage head borer. Here the larvae is about 12 to 15 mm in length, and the fully grown larvae is pupate in the larval burrow or in the soil. Here the site of pupation is in the soil, and the pupal period is 6 days. At early stages, it is in light green in color. This is the early stage of the Helula andalis. And this is the late instar of the Helula andalis. Coming to the nature of damage, at the early instars feed on the leaves by causing the irregular holes on the leaves, and later it bore into the stalk, stem, and even it feed on the head also. The activity of these cabbage head borer is from early stage of the crop to the early stage of the crop to up to the harvesting stage, because it feeds on leaves and also on the head of the cabbage, and this leads to the symptoms like webbed leaves. Here the group of leaves are webbed together. This leads to the webbed leaves. And on, if we cut open the head, the holes are present on the head with fecal matter. This is the cabbage head infested with the Helula andalis. Here the leaves, you can observe the fecal matter present in the head. And the next pest is cabbage leaf webber. Scientific name is Crocidolomia pavonana. It belongs to the family Pyralidae and the order Lepidoptera. Coming to the distribution, it is present in all localities wherever the cabbage and cauliflower crops are grown. Next, coming to the marks of identification. Here the moth is, here the forewings of the moth are light brownish in color. Here the moth is small in size. And it lay the eggs in 4 to 5 masses in 4 to 5 egg masses in her lifetime. And on each egg mass, it contain about 40 to 100 eggs. And these eggs are overlapped flat eggs. And the shape of the egg is flat eggs, overlapped flat eggs. After the here the incubation period is 5 to 15 days. After the incubation period, the larvae will emerge out, and here the larvae is brown in color with brown. Here the entire body of the larvae is with brown longitudinal stripes, and the head is reddish brown in color. And the entire body is with red brown longitudinal stripes, and it has a row of tubercles. And the entire body of it has a row of tubercles on the dorsal side of the larvae with short hairs on its body. And it becomes fully developed within 24 to 27 days. After that, and the next stage is the pupal stage. Here the pupation takes place in an earthen cocoon or in the soil. And within 7 days, the adult will emerge out, and the life is, and it completes its life cycle in about 14 to 20 days. Here the important thing is a scientific name, Crocidolomia pavonana, cabbage leaf webber. And the for marks of identification, here the larvae is has the red head with brown longitudinal stripes on the body, and a row of tubercles with short hairs on its pale olivaceous green colored body. Next, coming to the nature of damage, the early instars feed on the leaves, feed on the chlorophyll content of the leaves. It leads to the skeletonization of the leaves. And At first, it generally webbers means it will feed on the leaves by secreting the silken threads. It will gather the surrounding leaves and form a web-like webbed leaves, and it feed within the web and feed on the leaves, flowers, and heads. And if you open these webbed leaves, you can observe the larvae with the fecal matter. And the symptoms of damage are skeletonized leaves and the webbed leaves with fecal matter. And this is the cabbage head heavily infested with the leaf webber. For these three pests, diamond back moth and a cabbage head borer and a cabbage leaf webber, the management practices are same for these three pests. Under cultural practice, you have to remove and destroy the infected or remnant or stubbles or any plant debris in the field immediately after harvesting of the crop. And collect and destroy the larvae or egg masses in the field. And one of the important cultural practice is a growing of a trap crop. Trap crop such as the mustard. Trap crop means if the infestation of these pests will occur, the larvae will prefer to feed on these trap crops so that the percentage of infestation to the main crop is reduced. Here the mustard as a trap crop, and it should be sown twice in a crop, and the first sowing should be done at 12 days before transplanting of this cabbage or cauliflower, and the second sowing should be done at 45 days after the transplanting. And these mustard crops should be sown for every 25 rows, means 25 rows of the cabbage or cauliflower crop. For every 25 rows of the crop, host crop, 2 rows of mustard crop has to be sown as a trap crop. And the next is installation of pheromone traps. Installation of pheromone traps will attract the adults. And coming to the biological control, release of larval parasites like Apantelis plutella and Apantelis ruficrus and Diadigma semiglossum at the rate of 50,000 adults per hectare. And this is the important larval parasite of the DBM, diamond back moth, Apantelis plutella and Diadigma semiglossum. And the pupal and the release of these pupal parasites like Brachymeria excarinata. This is the pupal parasite of DBM. And otherwise, foliar spray of 5% neem seed kernel extract or a spraying of cypermethrin at the rate of 1 ml per liter or fenvalerate at the rate of 1 ml per liter or deltamethrin at the rate of 1 ml per liter or cartap hydrochloride at the rate of 175 grams per hectare or quinolfos or spinosad at the rate of 0.3 ml per liter. Under severe infestation, we can recommend the cypermethrin at the rate of 1 ml per liter or fenvalerate at the rate of 1 ml per liter or deltamethrin at the rate of 1 ml per liter will effectively control the DBM, diamond back moth. Or otherwise, spray the Bacillus thuringiensis at the rate of 1 kg per hectare. And these spraying of these BT formulation on 30 and 45 days after transplanting. This is about the management of the diamond back moth, cabbage head borer, and cabbage leaf webber. For all these pests, this is the management. And the next pest is mustard aphid and the cabbage aphid, Brevicornia brassicae. It belongs to the family Aphididae and the order Homoptera. Coming to the distribution, these aphid is polyphagous pest, polyphagous sucking pest, and it has a wide range of distribution. Coming to the marks of identification, here these aphids will reproduce based on the surrounding weather conditions. In summer, it reproduces by parthenogenetic type of reproduction, and in case of mild winter, it reproduces by viviparous type. And in case of severe winter, it reproduces by sexual reproduction. Here, the eggs are pale yellowish in color with greenish tinge. The eggs are pale yellowish in color with greenish tinge, and the eggs are laid under surface of the leaves. Here the eggs are stalked eggs, and the site of oviposition is underside or lower side of the leaf. And here the damaging stages are the nymph and adult. These are the nymphs. Nymphs are light yellowish in color. The difference between nymph and the adult is a color variation. The nymphs are light yellowish in color and the adults are blackish in color. Here the nymphs are about 1 to 1.5 mm in length. And the adults are 1.8 to 2 mm in length. Here the nymph matures in about 2 weeks. And it feeds on the sap content of the plant by this piercing and sucking type of mouth parts. By remaining underside or lower side of the leaf, it leads to the yellowish spots and curling and crinkling of the leaves. These are the symptoms of the cabbage aphid, Brevicornia brassicae. Here these insects will colonize under the underside of the leaves of the tender shoots and suck the sap from the tissue, and it leads to the stunted growth of the plant and poor head formation. In case of severe infestation, the plant will be completely dried up and it may even die. And this is the symptom of curling and crinkling of the leaves. And these adult will secrete the honeydew secretion on the leaf surface. On these honeydew secretion, the soot, blackish colored sooty mold will develop. This is the sooty mold symptom. As a result of the growth of these sooty mold, it leads to the reduced photosynthetic activity of the plant, and it adversely affect the foliage health, and it leads to the poor head formation, or it leads to the reduced head formation. It may affect the yield of the cabbage. This is about the symptoms of damage. Coming to the management, as soon as the aphid infestation occur, first you have to collect the infested leaves or shoots and destroy them. And after that, the cultural practice is a very well known cultural practice, installation of yellow sticky traps. And the one of the border crop we have to sow, that is the coriander as a border crop. and one of the important entomopathogenic fungi, that is the Verticillium lichani. This will effectively control the aphid population and also the larval parasites like Chrysoparla carniae or Coccinella septum punctata or Cirpus species. These are the important larval parasites, Chrysoparla carniae and Coccinella septum punctata or Cirpus species. Or otherwise, spray the following chemicals, following insecticides like dimethoate 30 EC at the rate of 2 ml per liter, or methyl dimetone 25 EC at the rate of 2 ml per liter, or imidacloprid or phosphomidone at the rate of 2 ml per liter. This is about the cabbage aphid, Brevicornia brassicae. And the next important pest is cabbage butterfly. Pieris, and the scientific name is Pieris brassica. And the another species is present, that is the Pieris rapi. It belongs to the family Pieridae and the order Lepidoptera. Coming to the marks of identification, here the eggs are laid underside of the leaves. A single female lays about 2 to 3 egg masses in her lifetime, and on each egg mass 50 to 80 eggs are present. Here we can here the eggs are yellowish in shape, yellowish in color, and are flask shaped. These are the flask shaped yellowish eggs on the underside of the leaves. Coming to the larval caterpillar marks of identification, here the fully grown larva is about 38 to 44 mm in length, and the larva is velvety bluish green in color with black dots. Here on the dorsal side of the larva, bluish green in color with black spots. And the lateral side of the larva, yellowish dorsal and lateral stripes are present. These are the yellowish stripes on the lateral side of the larva. And the entire body of the larva is covered with the hairs, with the white hairs. And here the pupation takes place on the leaf. Here the pupa is yellowish green in color with black spot on the pupae. Coming to the adult marks of identification, and this is important adult marks of identification. Here the adult butterfly has the snow white colored wings, snow white whitish light yellowish colored wings, snow colored white wings. And on the distal margin of the forewings, black spots are present. Here you can observe, this is the adult of the cabbage butterfly. On the distal margin of the forewing, black dots are present. This is the marks of identification for Pieris brassicae. This symbol represents the male. This is the male Pieris brassicae, and this is the female. Here the wings are snow white in color with black spots and dots on the margins of the wings. This is the Pieris brassicae, male and female. And this is the Pieris canida, male and female. Here the black distal margins, these black, you can clearly observe that these black spots are well well developed in case of female than the males. This is the female cabbage butterfly. That the black spots are well developed on the male butterfly. These black spots are absent. Here, this is about the marks of identification of the cabbage butterfly, Peris brassicae. Coming to the nature of damage, on hatching of these caterpillars, here the damage, caterpillar is the damaging stage. Only the caterpillar will cause damage to the leaves and the head of the cabbage. After hatching of these young caterpillars, it feed gregariously on the leaves, means a heavy skeletonization of the leaves. And then it spread in the entire field. At early instars, it feed within the one plant, and at later the late instars will spread in the end. It spread entire in the field. As a result, it leads to the skeletonization of the leaves, and it also feed on the heads of the cabbage and cauliflower. Coming to the management, handpicking and destruction of the caterpillars during early stages, it will prevent the further infestation of the leaves and stop the spreading of these caterpillars to the rest of the plants. Here the important parasite is Apantelis glomeratus. In case of heavy infestation, we can spray the dichlorvas or malathion or carbaryl at the rate of 3 grams per liter. And the last pest is painted bug. The scientific name is Bagrada cruciferarum. It belongs to the family Pentatomidae and the order Hemiptera. Coming to the distribution, and this is one of the major pests of various brassica species and the other cruciferous crops. Here the activity of adult bug appeared during the October month, and their activity decreases with onset of the summer, and again it accelerated in the autumn season. Coming to the marks of identification, here the eggs are laid singly or in batches of 2 to 12 on a single leaf. Here the site of oviposition is on leaves, stem, or even on the flower buds. Here the eggs are oval in shape, and these are the eggs of the painted bug, Bagrada cruciferarum. Eggs are oval shaped, and the freshly laid eggs are pale yellowish in color, and later they become pinkish orange in color. And this is the early instar of the nymph. Here the damaging stage are the nymph and the adult. This is the early instar of the nymph. Here the nymph is pinkish orange in color, and it is about 1.5 to 4.5 in length, and the color changes depending on their age. At early instars, they are in orange yellowish in color, and later they develop the different colors on their dorsal side of the body of alternate stripes of red, black, white, orange colored. Both the nymph and adult are similar in their appearance. And this is about the painted bug, Bagrada cruciferarum, biology of the painted bug. This is the painted bug. Here we can clearly observe the different colors of black, orange, white colored patterns on the adult. This is the adult of Bagrada cruciferarum, painted bug. Coming to the nature of damage, these both nymph and adult suck the sap from the tender parts of the plant and causes the yellowing of the leaves. It gradually leads to the drying of the plant, and ultimately sometimes the plant may fall down, and it leads to the secondary infestation of the bacteria or fungi. The plant will wilt and wither, and adversely affect the yield both in quantitatively and qualitatively, and it leads to the symptoms like yellowing of leaves and wilting and loss of vigor of the plant. This is about symptoms of painted bug. Coming to the management, here the important cultural practice is clean cultivation by removing weeds harboring this pest and avoid the infestation of these bugs. Otherwise, spray the insecticides like dichlorvas, fosolone, or dimethoate or methyl dimetone at a recommended dosage. And here, after spraying of these chemical insecticides in any vegetable crops, the waiting period should be at least about 7 to 10 days. And we should not harvest the crop immediately after the spraying of these insecticides. There should be 7 to 10 days of waiting period. And the next important thing is IPM for cruciferous vegetables. Cruciferous pests. Here the one of the important cultural practices, growing of mustard trap crop at the rate of two rows per every 25 rows of the crop, and it should be sown twice in a crop duration. First sowing should be at 12 days before transplanting of the cabbage or cauliflower crop. And the second sowing should be at 45 days after transplanting. Or grow the trap crop such as the Chinese cabbage will also effectively control the DBM. And select the varieties or prefer the varieties having the shining leaves. Means by having these characters, the diamond back moth will the preference will be less for these shiny leaves. Here, one of the important resistant variety is PI234599 is a variety resistant to the DBM. Or otherwise, a planting of marigold as a trap crop will reduce the larval population of the cruciferous pest. And or otherwise, install the pheromone traps or yellow sticky traps will reduce the infestation of the adult moth, will trap the adult moth. Or otherwise, release of larval parasitoids like Apantelis plutella or Cotisia plutella. Or another important larval parasite is Brachymeria excarinata. Otherwise, spray the BT formulation at the rate of 200 grams per acre. Or the fungi Beveria bassiana at the rate of 500 ml per acre. Otherwise, 5% neem, spray the 5% neem seed kernel extract. Whenever the incidence is observed, spray these formulations. Under severe infestation, we can spray the following insecticides like cypermethrin, chlorpyrifos, or spinosad, or carthop hydrochloride. These are deltamethrin. These five insecticides, these six insecticides, among any one of these six insecticides will effectively control the pest like DBM, cabbage head borer, leaf borer, and the cabbage butterfly. This is about the IPM of cruciferous vegetables, insect pests of cruciferous vegetables. Okay, thank you. Yeah.